Hello guys, welcome to this course on Apache Hadoop. My name is Sijish and this video we will see how to install Apache Hadoop on CentOS. So this is the first part, and this part we will mainly look into the prerequisites. So first let's check the operating system we are using. It's a CentOS 7.5 and it's deployed in Oracle VirtualBox. So I have uploaded some videos on how to install Oracle VirtualBox and how to create VirtualBox or how to use OSBox image. Okay, so you can refer that video and deploy your own operating system. So I have one VM which is up and running and it's with CentOS 7.5. So as part of Hadoop installation, so you need to follow some prerequisites. So we are using the same set of prerequisites here also. The first thing, we are changing the run level. So it's a multi-user mode. By default, maybe if you are using OSBox image, so it will boot in the graphical mode. So we don't need that graphic. So we just need the terminal and multi-user terminal mode. So we can use this command systemctl set default multi-use target command to change the run level. Okay, so it's always better to change to multi-user target mode to get much better performance. So use that command to do that. So next we need to set this host name. So by default we will see what is a host name. So it's OS boxes. So we need some different host name like master.hadoop.com. So we can use the hostnamectl command to set the hostname. So we can verify that using the hostname command. Now we can see the hostname has changed to master1.hadoop.com. So we will get the IP address. So it's 192.168.1.4. And we need to update that detail into etc host. We will take the IP address and hostname. And okay, so let's clear this terminal and open etc host. So this is the file where we are writing the host name, I mean IP address and host name resolution. So if you have DNS in place, so you need not to do this task. So here we are using the IP address, fully qualified name and a short name. Then next we need to disable the firewall. So you have two options. So either disable the firewall or open the port. So if you are doing it into a production kind of environment or you are doing it in an enterprise level, so you may not be able to stop this. There may be some other firewall available. So we need to open the ports, whatever the ports you are using. The next, we can change that VM swappiness to 10. So VM swappiness is the value which control when to use virtual memory. So if you have the value VM swappiness 10, that means when your 90% of physical memory is used, then it start using virtual memory. So let's use or set VM swappiness to 10. So both Cloudera and Hortonworks recommends this value. Again, if you are not doing these changes like VM swappiness and all, your cluster will work, but the performance will be a problem. And next is we need NTP. So NTP is network time protocol, which is used to sync the time across all the host. So this is very much needed if you are using Kerberos enabled environment. And once you have installed that, so you need to turn on that NTP service by using systemctl command, so that next reboot onwards the service will be up and running. And also we need to add the user, so we can use the command user add to add that. Then we can set the password using the password command. So type some password here and again retype the same password to confirm. So now we can switch to that user. Sorry, there is some typo, so it I have to change that to SU. So SU for switching the user. So once it's we are here, so we can create the SSH keys. Apache Hadoop startup commands depends on passwordless SSH, so you need to have that. So first we use SSH keygen -t rsa, and again So selecting everything as default by keep on pressing enter. Now you can see there will be a directory .ssh created as part of this command. And if you go inside that directory, you can see two files, idrsa and idrsapub. Idrsa is a private key and its corresponding public key is idrsa.pub. And basically we need to rename or copy this idrsapub to authorize key. So that we can do with the ssh copy id. And the argument we are passing here as the host name. And once prompted, confirm and type the password. So now we can do ssh without password. So ssh master1.hadoop.com. So it will go without asking password. So we need this passwordless ssh for the startup or stopping of Hadoop services. So next we need to download the packages for Java. So we have option to download this. I will be adding that these links in the description. So here you have option to download tarball file or RPM. So I'll be using this tarball file and you have to accept the license and download. So once you have downloaded that, so you can transfer this file to this host using WinSCP or some other utility. And the next thing you need is Hadoop tarball, so that also you can download. So you can choose the version. So which I used is 2.70, and you are okay to use some other versions also, so that you can get from this URL. So you can download these files and transfer it to this host master1.hadoop.com using WinSCP or some other utility. So that's it about the prerequisites. I hope you enjoyed this video. So we will see in the next video. Thank you.